2023 will be the biggest year yet for AEW. I have major announcements coming soon that are important to AEW and our fans.
Oh, man. Well, this is the one thing that will be true. It will be important to only their fans. Their immediate, small, niche fan base.
Tony didn't learn. He didn't learn the Dixie Carter lesson. He really didn't. I mean, Dixie Carter, maybe people forgot, but she used to come out there almost on a weekly basis with these major announcements that were just lackluster and worthless. Some of them were just as simple as her promoting the event or somebody being at the event. And it's like Tony Khan has been giving some dud major announcements that nobody even really gives a shit about. And it's not endearing. It makes you look kind of silly and cheap. It makes you look needy. Oh, guys, you got to tune in because I have a secret. I have a secret.
Guess what? You're going to have a reality show. It's like, right. No one fucking cares.
Right.
No one cares. And the fact that hundreds of thousands of people didn't watch the show the next week because you egged them on with the announcement of a fucking shitty show.
Yeah.
That keep playing that card and see how it goes. Now, that said, I'm really starting to believe that, you know, not that it can't go lower and it can't get higher, but somewhere around that 750,000 range, that seems to be it. You know what I mean? Like, that seems like as good as it's going to get,
right,
for them. And that's where it's going to remain. I don't know. I don't know. Like, what's the announcement going to be? Even if even if on Sunday he comes out and he's like, CM Punk is coming back, people would be excited, of course, and interested to see what he's going to do. But does anybody have any faith in any of it making sense?
No.
Does anybody have faith in a story being half decent? Does anybody have any faith that CM Punk is going to come back and be motivated or care or even remain healthy? So what are you going to do?
Right.
What is there left? WWE ain't fucking firing people, ain't getting rid of anybody. It's not really anybody hanging around in the market that you can go out there and pick up and big surprise for you. And everybody you've gotten that has been worth a nickel, you've made into a penny.
Sure. Well,
so
it's even as bad as the crowd. So we had one of our friends, Matt, from the Patreon page and stuff like that.
Yeah,
he was at
the
event.
Yeah,
right. And it's like this was Dynamite. There's a picture of Dynamite in there with literally nobody in the back rows, nobody on the first shelf, and nobody even on the second tier. So there's like nobody there. And this is supposed to be this Dynamite company that's facing down WWE, willing to take them out of commission. And he was saying that the tickets are buy one, get one at this point. There's a lot of people that are paying for tickets and getting free tickets, which is true. I remember when me and Krauser and everybody, even at the CM Punk thing, we found tickets for 2 cents. And it was a gag. And people right. Like, oh, you're full of shit. And I'm going on the fucking website as we get closer and closer to the time. And you're finding tickets for 30 cents, 25 cents. And it got all the way down to 2 cents.
Oh, which, it's one thing if that happens at a WrestleMania where there's 75,000 seats or whatever the hell. But when it's just a regular ass arena, that's not good.
Well, that's crazy that they can't even give away tickets. I mean, when you're giving when you're selling a seat for 2 cents, you're giving away those tickets. You're literally giving away those tickets, man.
You're actually making it more of a problem charging them 2 cents.
Right, because it's going to cost them more in taxes and every other fucking thing.
Right. You might as well, like you said, you might as well just stand out in front of the place and be like, who wants free shit?
Right.
Who
and the fact that people
in?
Won't even show up for that, that's mind-blowing. That really shows how bad this is doing in general. Like, when you're here, AEW, brand new, fresh product, new wrestlers, old wrestlers, a mix of, like, crazy, wacky wrestling, And we got crazy Tony Khan too, you know? And it's like, you guys can't give away the tickets.
Yeah, they can't. And it's the fact that it's not more openly discussed and a conversation shows you that it's just completely, the only people that are left that are really talking about this thing that aren't people who are attempting to make sense of it and they're few and far between is just complete delusional fandom.
Right. Oh, yeah. Hey,
it's all it is.
Promoter of the year, guys, right there.
Promoter of the year. Look at that, dude. People swinging from the rafters. Like,
just, it would have been better just taking the seats out. Just fucking take the seats out. There's no floor seats, anybody. Just, it's going to be one giant ring with 90 feet of room.
You know what? He should just, I mean, Tony should invest in some tarps. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like fire, you know, just fire a couple of these guys and just take their salary and buy some tarps.
Oh, please. Anna, don't. Anna's making fun of this poor dude who's a big guy sitting on those seats. They love people like him because he takes up two chairs, Anna.
Right. He makes the
team. He's double the fan. They want big boys at AEW. The bigger, the better.
Makes the building look full.
Shit.
Oh, my God. AEW proudly presents free pizza.
Free pizza for fat guys. Yeah. Hey, do you weigh over 250 pounds? Come on down and get yourself a free pizza in an AEW show.
What are they all?
You know what? That would fucking work, wouldn't it? Wouldn't that work? If you seriously think about that, that is a gimmick and a half right there. They could even do it where they have like the little fucking the scales by the door and shit. Oh, this man here gets a free pizza. Step on the scale. Oh, this man here gets a free pizza. Step on the scale. And then you can promote some kind of pizza chain because they love attaching themselves to advertising and shit like that. Why not, right? It's free press, yeah. Free money. They can get like a Papa John's on there or some shit. And then Papa John's gives away like, you know, 1,000 free pizzas or some. Come on, dude.
Shaq sitting there. He's like, yeah, I'm going to give them free pizzas if, you know, 300 plus pounds, you get into the AEW show for free.
That's right. And it's free promotion. It looks good all the way around. And you know what? You have at least 1,000 dudes that are real fucking happy eating a pizza right there. Because even if the show sucks, right? Even if it is the shittiest wrestling show known to man, you know what they're going to remember? Dude, I got in and I got a free pizza.
Everybody's just sitting there.
Oh, even the shittiest pizza in the world is great when it's free. Come on.
Yeah. It was just cheesy bread. Like someone just eating cheesy bread while the fucking people go out there and they're just like, are you guys right? Yeah. Fucking Sammy Guevara's falling off a 20-foot ladder and someone's just like, ah, damn. And they're just holding a garlic. Oh, man. Crazy. That's just as calmly as possible. Watching him drive his body into fucking dust. Just like,
I think the only thing that you'd have to worry about though, Joe, is you'd have to tarp down the bathrooms, right? I'm thinking at that point, you're just gonna have to lay like black plastic bags, trash bags all over the floor. Cause there might be a lot of accidents. 300 pounds of man eating a full pizza like that, somebody's running to the bathroom.
I think that Jeff Jarrett would have to change the name of his finisher as to not rile up the audience. You know what I mean? He'd be like, I'm going to do the stroke. Nope. Don't say it. Try to not remind him.
That's right.
We don't want him thinking about it.
Oh, you know what I mean? Man.
Follow WrestleSoup on Twitter at WrestlingSoup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.